Hello everyone, how are you all? Hope you are doing well. I'm Shweta and welcome to the maths class of Standard 3. I'm teaching chapter number 7, Geometry, and this is video number 3 of this chapter. So till the last video, we already have discussed about the plane figures, solid figures, okay, and the point, line and line segment. One thing I want to make it clear here, while teaching about the 2D shapes, I have told you that 2D shapes have two dimensions, length and height. This is not height, okay? In the fluency of speaking, I have told that the length and height, it should be length and width, okay? 2D shape means what? We have to make that shapes in the flat surface. Like suppose you have to make a rectangle on the floor. Then how you will make? You will draw the four lines, okay? But that rectangle is not in height. It is only on the flat surface, okay? So what are the things are there in the flat surface? Length and width. Like this, we have to draw the rectangle on the flat surface. Then this should be the length and this should be the width, okay? This does not contain the height. The 2D shape we have to draw only on the flat surface. Okay, so after that, in this video, we will cover the two things, the open figure and the closed figure. So, let us start. So, first we will look for the closed figure. As already we have learned about the plane figures, so, and we already have learned about the points, that this is point. And when we will join these points with the help of a ruler, then this will become the line, okay? And all the shapes we have to draw with the help of lines only, okay? All the shapes are made up of lines. So, what happens in the closed figure? In the closed figure, the shapes must contain the same starting and end point. What does that mean? Suppose here I have given 3 points. Now here I have given the fourth point. Okay. First I have drawn a line from this point to this point. Then from this point to this point. Now I have given the point D. Okay. Now I have drawn a line from C to D. And if I will make a line from D to A, means the starting and end point both are same. I have started drawing a line from A point and I have ended to A point. Okay, so this is closed figure. In closed figure, the starting and end point are same. Okay, as I have written here, figures or shapes having same starting and end points are called closed figures. I have made 4 points A, B, C and D. Okay, then I have started from point A. Then I made a line to point B. Then I made a line to point C, B to C, and then C to D, and then D to A. So, here I have written point A is both starting and end point. Okay, so just pause this video and write these things in your maths copy. Now, what is open figure? In open figure, the starting and end points are different. Suppose I have given here point A, then point B and then point C, okay, or point D also, and I have drawn a line from A to B, then B to C and then C to D, but I have not drawn a line from D to A. Now this is my figure. So this is an open figure, means here the starting point is A but the end point is D. So this is the open figure. Understood? As I have written here, open figure, figures having different end point and starting point are called open figures. Like here, 4 points I made first, A, B, C and D. Then I joined point A to point B. Okay? Then point B to point C and then point C to point D. So here in this figure, you can see the starting point is A while the end point is point D. So just pause this video and write these things also in your maths copy. Now here are the three questions I have made, three figures I have made, and we have to find out that these figures are open figure or closed figure. Okay, so first we will look at the first figure, that is A. So here, as you can see, we have started our line from this place. Okay, and after that we gone through these area and in after drawing figure at this place. So here the both the starting and end points are different. Okay, so we can write here open figure. This is an open figure. Now the second one, in this you can see I have made a circle. Okay, this circle, if you will draw any circle, from where you will start making the circle, you have to end at the same point. Okay, so this is a closed figure. Okay, now the third one, here I have made a figure. In this you can see this is the starting point. Okay, this is the starting point, and after that we have gone through these areas and ended our drawing, our figure at this position. So here again you can see both the starting and end points are different. So this is an open figure. Understood? So just pause this video and write these examples in your maths copy. Now the third topic of today's video is symmetry. Symmetry means mirror image. Symmetry means mirror image. What do you mean by mirror image? If you will just put half your face near the mirror, okay, half you just hide, okay, then what you will see, the reflection of half of your face can be seen in the mirror. So all together it will make a full face. Okay, suppose I have hidden my half face, okay, and here I have put a mirror, then what I can see in the reflection of this mirror, if I will do like this, then the half, the reflection of this half face we can see here in the mirror. Okay, so all together we can see the full face here. Okay, so symmetry means the mirror image. Like, as you can see here in a paper, I have written something. It is not clear that what I have written. Means here I have written a half letter. Okay, so how we can see that what I have written? We will just fold this paper. Okay, and then what we will see, that the whole color, the color is also spreaded on the other side. So what the letter it became? A. Okay, this is A, alphabet A written here. So similarly like that, this is the line from where I have folded the paper, is the line of symmetry. Means both the halves are same. Okay, both the halves are same. Like I had drawn something here, the half thing I have drawn. Now we have to find out the full thing. So what we have to do, we have to just fold this paper. Okay, from the middle we will just fold this paper so that the color will also spread at the next half, to the next half. Okay, now we can see that what are the thing here, what is the thing here. Now you can see this is a picture of a leaf. Now you can also see that the line from where we have folded this paper, this is the line of symmetry. Means this line divides the both part, and both part are equal. Okay, so these two halves are mirror image. Okay, and this line is the line of symmetry. Understood? So as I have written here, symmetry. Okay, an object or thing is said to be symmetrical when both of its halves are exactly the same. Okay, already I have given you an example. Here also I have made the same examples, A, and these dotted lines are line of symmetry. Okay, here also I made a leaf and these dotted line are line of symmetry. Like like these things, our body also have a line of symmetry. If we will draw a line, then we can see that the both halves of our body are same. Okay, so just pause this video and write these examples also in your maths notebook. Now, after symmetry, we have to learn about the patterns. What are patterns? Patterns are all around us. If you will just look at your window, the grills are also in the same pattern. Okay, means the same design is repeated several times. Okay, so this is the pattern. So similarly like that written here, we get the pattern when the same design or pictures or number is repeated. Okay, like here I have given two examples. This I have made a tuning light. Okay, in this the first light is of circle in shape, while the second light is an oval in shape. Okay. And again the third one is in circle in shape and the fourth one is in oval in shape. So in this we are following the pattern that first we have to give the circle, then oval, circle, oval, circle, oval. Okay. So this tuning light is following a pattern. Similarly like this, here also I have made some shapes. Which kind of shapes are there? Triangle. First I have drawn a triangle, then a square. Again triangle, again a square. So here I'm just following the pattern triangle, square, triangle, square, triangle, square. So these are the pattern. Means if any design or picture or number is repeated, okay, then it is called as pattern. So just pause this video and write these examples also in your maths notebook. Now the last topic of this chapter is tilling. What is tilling? When we used to form a design, when we used to make a design with a same shape, okay, we used to repeat the same shapes in all over the design, then it is called tilling. Like if I will made like this, here I made the diamond shape, okay, again here I made a diamond shape, here again I made a diamond shape, okay, then here again I made a diamond shape. So here what I am doing, I am making just a design with the same shape. Okay, I am repeating the same shape. Okay, to make the design. So this is called as tilling. So you can also write these things about the tilling and draw these examples in your maths notebook.